वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्तम् बिंदावनम् मनोहर वांछाकल्पतरुवश्य कृपा सिंधुभ्यवचो पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयतगिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधव वृंदावई तुलसीदेवई पियावई केशवस्य कृष्णभक्तिपरदे देवी सत्त्वत्वयी नमो नमः। नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे। संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीय पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्तो भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदूहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरंचनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतातिहम् पुनतपाल भवद्विभूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविंदम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमणिच्छटाय विस्फुरजीत किमपि गोपवधूस्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौर भक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदतो संकेतनैकवितरो कमलायताक्षो विशाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। नमामि गंगे तव पादपंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपम् भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारम् वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथम् वागीशजस्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवितं नृसिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। Naham Vishanke Suraraj Vajrat Nastar Kushulat Najamo Sadanyat Nagnar Kosoma Nilavita Pastrat Chanke Vrsam Brahmakula Vamanat Naham Vishanke Suraraj Vajrat Nastar Kushulat Najamo Sadanyat Nagnar Kosoma Nilavita Pastrat Chanke Visham Brahmakula Vamana Gaudiya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur repeatedly told that if Guru Darshan is not complete, then it is quite impossible to go for Bhagavad Darshan. Through Guru Darshan, we can get Bhagavad Darshan. Otherwise, Bhagavad Darshan is impossible. Any kind of doubts there about Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, Guru Vaishnava can cut it very easily. But one condition is there. If you are going to do aparadha unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. Pure Guru Vaishnava means those who are established in Nam Tattva, those who are Nam Brahma. In that case, you cannot get any excuse. Nam Harinam Prabhu is very merciful, and those pure Guru Vaishnava, those who are totally established in Nam Tattva, they can realize through their Harinam, they can see Supreme Lord, His pastime, everything they can see clearly. They can see clearly. They need not go to Jagannath temple, pushing and dashing. They can go to the altar in front of the Jagannath, they can see. Not that. You can go. You can spend thousands of rupees, lakhs of rupees, but there is no surety that you can get Krishna Darshan, Bhagavad Darshan, Govindo, Radha, Samshundar, no surety. But those Guru Vaishnav, they are clearly, they can see all Lila Tattva, everything there. Actually, the other day I was speaking that Supreme Lord is taking rest inside the heart of pure Guru Vaishnava. Supreme Lord always feeling relaxed inside the heart of pure Guru Vaishnava. So, Prabhupada speaking, pure Guru Vaishnava is a living temple of Supreme Lord. Pure Guru Vaishnava is the living temple of Supreme Lord. You can get directly. So many times I told before, suppose you are going to enjoy full kripap on pure Guru Vaishnava, then be sure you are going to enjoy full kripap of Bhagavan. Sure. If you are going to get full kripap of Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, then be sure you are already enjoying the kripap of Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. But about Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing one article very in details that due to aparadha inside your heart, we cannot feel Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, we cannot realize the transcendental feature of Guru Vaishnava, Nam, Dham, nothing. We cannot realize because of Nam aparadha. Because of Nam aparadha, Vaishnava aparadha, there is one kind of insulation. So we cannot come in contact with aprakrit jagat. No way. There is no, you know, possibility. So Ruhugam speaking in front of Jara Bharatji, Naham Bisanke Suraraj Vairat, I am not going to fear the Vajra thunder of Indra Maharaj of heaven. King Indra Maharaj. Naham Bisanke Suraraj Vairat. Nastarko Sugulat na Jomasa Dandyas. Starko meet Shankar Bhagavan. His trident, I am not going to fear. Jomasa Dandyas, Jomdev Maharaj, he has one weapon. I am not going to fear. Nagnar Kunila Samavitta Pastat, Agni Dev is missile, I am not going to fear. Jaladevata, water, Barundev, nothing, I am not going to fear. I fear heavily that Brahma Kulabhamanat, somehow knowingly or unknowingly, if I am going to commit mistake, aparadha unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, then it is very dangerous. If I am going to do some knowingly or unknowingly, because aparadha is there, knowingly, unknowingly, anyhow you are doing aparadha. Aparadha is aparadha. You will have to, yeah. But regarding pap, in Kalikal there is some grace, guess me, some facility. You know, so many people doing pap. Mental pap is also dangerous. But after diksha, all pap you can burn up very easily. You can, all pap and up, anything can be burned up. Now actually, after diksha, if we are not going to believe in Bhagavat Tattva, in Guru Vaishnava Tattva, in that case, be sure there is some big aparadha. Otherwise, after diksha, what to speak about after diksha? Before taking diksha, when I am taking decision to take diksha, by that time I am sure that I am going to feeling something. I am feeling something which is not 100% positive, but still I am feeling that there is some transcendental world, a prakrit jagat, though no direct information at present, still, before diksha, after diksha, no question, because already you believe in aprakita dam, nam, tata, everything. That's why you have taken diksha, na? Then after that, if you are not going to get enjoyment in doing Harinam, if you are not going to get enjoyment, ananda, in Harikatha, if you are not going to get enjoyment regarding the aprakita vishaya, then be sure there is great aparadha. Tate yoni, in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, tate yoni, tate jani, aparadha achaya pachud. If I am not going to get any response inside my heart, then be sure, tate jani, then be sure there is great aparadha in it. So, first of all, we will have to eliminate all aparadha from our heart to understand aprakita Guru Vaishnava Tattva all the time. I like to discuss in details about Vaishnava Tattva, Guru Tattva, how they are exhibiting sometimes some such leela, so that we cannot believe how it can be. So, that Ruhugon is speaking in front of Jarabharaji again, when there was different kind of logical interpretation inside the heart of Ruhugan. Ruhugan one by one putting on logic to understand the Tattva. But so long as we are going to take help of logical interpretation, then be sure we cannot understand aprakita Tattva. From logical interpretation, aprakita Tattva, Prabhupada speaking, get banished. The Param Satya Vastu, from debate, from logical interpretation, that aprakita Param Satya get banished from in front of me. Get banished. He cannot come in front of me. I mean, Bhagavat Tattva mean all, Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, and Dham Tattva, all. I cannot realize. Be careful. So, in front of Jarabharaji Maharaj, our, you know, these Ruhugan speaking, Nahi adbhutam tat charanabjarena vira hata anghaso bhakti radhakshaya amala mahurtikat jasya samagama chame dustarka mula apato abivekaha. Nahi adbhutam, it is not a strange. It is not at all surprising, it is not at all strange that I cut all my argument, all my ignorance, all my, you know, logical, you know, logic, all I clean. Nahi adbhutam. It is not strange. Nahi adbhutam tat charanab jarenavir hatang haso hatang hasam bhakti radhaksha jamala mahurtikat jasa samagama chame dustar kamulo apato avivekaha. Rohugan speaking, it is not strange that I cut all my doubts and everything, and I get gyan chakshu. Agyanati virandusa gyananjana salakya. I cut all my ignorance, all my, you know, suspicion. So now actually it is not strange, because a paramahansa like you, if they are going to give some kippa on me, I mean their dust particle from their lotus feet, if I am going to touch, then automatically I can get bhakti. Bhakti radhakshaja amala. Bhakti radhakshaja amala. Amala mean pure bhakti. So this is the condition. Prahlad Maharaj also speaking. Naishang mati stavaduru kramanghing sprishyatta narthap gamo jadato mahi asam padrajo visekam niskinchananam nabrinito javat. So long as I am not going to take bath, I am not going to take bath by the dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, then I cannot rectify my brain. So much power is there inside that dust particle from the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, that it is called Mahamahaprasadam. It's so great, and is sufficient, more than sufficient to give me bhakti. Bhakti radhakshaja amala, adhakshaja, akshaja and adhakshaja. Prabhupada speaking, if day by day I am doing bhajan, I have taken shelter. Really so? I have taken shelter unto lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. I am going to deserve. But for long time before I took Diksha, day by day I am growing material conception regarding Guru Vishnu, Bhagavan, everything. Prabhupada speaking, if this kind of akshajo conception growing, then be sure there is great fault, aparad. Otherwise it cannot happen so. Because pap, there can be countless pap. Pap are sinful activities. But sinful activities can get vanished by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava and their dust particle, from the lotus feet of their dust particle. It's number one medicine. So, nahi adbhutam tat charanabjaranavir hata anghasam bhakti radhakshaya amala mahurtikad jaccha mahurtikad jasso samagamat chame dustar kamul apato avivekaha. In very short period of time, I get your association. Mahurtikat jasso samagamat chame. By the association of a pure sadhu like you, mahurtikat jasso samagamat chame dustar kamulo. I mean the root cause of all, you know, logical interpretation. Dustar kamulo apato avivekaha. Dustar kamulo. It is dustarko mulo, even the root cause of all doubts, all eradicated already. So what to speak, I'm very happy. So this is the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava. By the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava, it is 100% possible to get bhakti. Bhakti radhakshaja amala, not ordinary bhakti. Bhakti radhakshaja amala. Amala bhakti means pure bhakti we can get, and no, there is no doubt we can get pure bhakti. Now Prabhupada speaking, there is big problem, because ordinary people, if their luck is very, very good, they can get the association of a pure Guru Vaishnava. Or Mayadevi is playing such a game, even if we meet with pure Guru Vaishnava, still we can express doubt. It is the arrangement of Mayadevi. Even suppose by we are lucky enough to meet with pure Guru Vaishnava, but still then we can grow some suspicion, grow some doubts, everything. That is the arrangement of Mayadevi. Prabhupada speaking, what to do in this Kalikal, this Kalikal, usually it is happening so. Prabhupada speaking, it is Kalikal, this Kal is very bad. So, in this Kalikal, usually people cannot believe Sadhuguru Vaishnava, Dham, Nam, nothing they can believe. If at all they believe, then their luck is very good, you think. And also there is problem, because in the name of Sadhu Sangha, if at all they are going to get Asadhu Sangha, then it's more trouble. You are going to get more problem. Because, Prabhupada speaking, at present in the name of Harikatha, Haribhajan, those who are going to cheat people, common people, they cannot understand, they are so foolish. They think it is Sadhu Sangha, it is Harikatha, they think so. So in the name of Haribhajan, Harikatha, those who are going to cheat people, we common people so foolish that we want to be cheated, that's why you are cheated. That's why I told many times, first point, before starting bhajan, your sincerity. Many times Guru Vaishnava appreciate you. Oh, you are doing nice seva, actually you are number one sevak of Guruji. Be careful, then he is going to cheat you. My Guru Maharaj also, in preliminary stage, wanted to cheat me many times. Oh, my son, you know this, that. So I see you are going to cheat me. So I go away. Prabhupada speaking, I am not ready to get that kind of bad luck. Prabhupada speaking, I am not ready to get that kind of bad luck as to hear my own appreciation from the mouth of Guru Vaishnava. It's very bad luck then. If I am going to hear my, appreciation Guru Vaishnava is going to do, I am going to hear directly, is very dangerous because they want to test me, cheat me. So all the time they want to test me, my seva mood, my faith in Guru Vaishnava, they always like to. So Prabhupada speaking, I don't like to get that kind of bad luck as to hear my own appreciation from the mouth of Guru Vaishnava. It's a bad luck, very bad luck. Anytime problem can happen. So all the time Guru Vaishnava is going to test me, so we must be very careful. So many times I told, nobody can cheat you 100%. Because it's the commitment of Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking, if you are going to follow Bhakti Vinod Dara, Prabhupada, it is the commitment, standing commitment of Prabhupada. If you are going to follow Bhakti Vinod Dara, then be careful. You need not be sure, then you need not go to join a cheating organization to get to lose everything. You need not. If you are going to follow Bhakti Vinod Dhara in toto, not I am following, but who told you? Who can give you certificate that you are going to follow Bhakti Vinod Dhara? If you are at all going to follow Bhakti Vinod Dhara, then I can promise that nobody can cheat you. Main point is that you are not following Bhakti Vinod Dhara in toto. Sometime you are following something, sometime not. So, if you are totally established in Bhakti Vinod Dhara, if you are going to follow Bhakti Vinod Dhara, then you can develop one kind of sensitivity that any time you hear Harikatha anywhere, any time you are going to get any Sangha, immediately inside your heart, that sensitivity can speak you, it is wrong, this association is bad association. This Harikatha is not transcendental or Prakita Harikatha. Immediately you can. Like, in our border, in a country border, there is some radar. If some enemy going to send some missile, some plane, rocket, everything coming, then immediately in radar, everything they can catch. So you can grow that kind of sensitivity if you at all hearing Harikatha from a pure Guru Vaishnava, If you at all going to believe that Guru Vaishnava, if you at all interested to follow Bhagavad, I mean Bhaktivinoda Dara, then automatically it's an automatic factor. You can develop that kind of sensitivity. Practically I'm speaking. I'm not speaking any false philosophy. I can show you directly. They're speaking to me, Maharaj, after hearing Harikatha, when somebody called me to hear Harikatha, I go, I can find immediately, it's all false, useless. It's not established in the Tatta. So immediately I can catch what is prasad, what is not prasad, what is satsanga, what is not satsanga, what is false, what is... everything I can realize. That kind of sensitivity can come inside your heart, provided you have sincerity 100%. Sincerity is the only property through which you are not going to lose anything. Sincerity. If there is no sincerity, then any time you can be cheated by somebody. Sincerity means 100% belief, faith, that pure Guru Vaishnava can give everything, pure Harikatha, everything. So, that kind of sensitivity we can grow. So, that's why Prabhupada is speaking. If you are going to follow Bhaktivinoda Dara, then be sure you need not go to other place to join a cheating party, cheating organization. So in the name of bhajan, you need not lose everything from your life, in your life. Be careful. That is a commitment by Prabhupada. So satsanga is very important thing. If at all from heart we can believe satsanga, do satsanga, I can promise you can get it. Because I get, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, something I am feeling. So this is why Prabhupada speaking, that actually those who are cheater, they are actually want to get escape. They are always searching some way out, escape. So they are going to speak that Prabhupada Prabhupada speaking in Bengali, chor wale oi chor, one thief speaking, hey, there is thief, chor wale oi chor, Prabhupada speaking. I know practically from Murshidabad, one devotee of Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj speaking to me, Maharaj, in front of us, in noontime, 11 o'clock, this thing happening. What happening? He say, one thief, he is taking one new cycle of a man and he is running. And the owner of the cycle is shouting, hey, my cycle is cheating, he is going away, catch, that man is thief. And that thief is so clever, he is laughing. And, you know, moving his hand and speaking, you cannot catch me, you cannot catch me, you cannot catch me, how you can catch me? Then ordinary public thinking, they are playing two friends maybe. They are playing, so maybe, so they are not going to catch it. He gone with cycle. So nice, you know. So this is the procedure. So this way, Prabhupada speaking, those who are thief, one thing we hear from Prabhupada, night guard, he is actually thief. And a night guard actually, night time he is doing night guard, but he is actually thief. He is habituated. He is going to a house, made up of, and going to cut the door, everything, going to steal. After that, somehow, the Grihastha could realize some thief coming. Then he's shouting, chor, chor, chor. Then the old village man, they are also coming outside, where is thief? Chor, chor, thief, thief. And the thief, he is also shouting, thief, thief, chor, chor, catch, catch, catch. Then people could not catch the thief, because the thief is there among them, who is shouting, who is thief. Prabhupada giving this example. If thief is shouting that thief, 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 there is thief, and then nobody can understand who is thief, who is not. So this kind of, this is the mood. So Prabhupada speaking, those who are going to follow, actually those who are going to follow Bhaktivinoda Thara, be sure, he can develop that kind of consciousness that nobody can cheat him. That is all, that is actually Kripa Balavji Maharaj. What do you mean by the Kripa Balavji Maharaj? What do you mean by Balav Kripa Balav Guru? Guru Kripa Balavji Maharaj. Kripa, if you are going to Kripa Balavji Maharaj, then material things cannot touch you. You can develop that kind of, many times I told before, Jesham so esha bhagavan daya eda ananta sarvatman asrita padam jodi nirvalikam. Jodi nirvalikam, be careful. Valik and nirvalik. So, te dustaran tiyotitaram chadeva maya mam no mamahumiti sa sigal bhakshi. Jesham so esha bhagavan bhagavan daya eda ananta sarvatman asrita padam jodi nirvalikam. Te dustaram atitaram ticha deva mayam na mamahumiti sa sigal bhakshe. No maya can touch him. And he is not going to express any false ego regarding his, you know, body or anything appliance related to this body or education related to this body. Nothing is not going to express, you know, any false ego. So jesam sa esha bhagavan daya eda ananta. If somebody is going to get the full kripa of Anantadev, Jesamsa Esha Bhagavan Dayoeda Ananta, Sarvatmana Asrita Padam Jodhinir, Sarvatmana Asrita Padam, wholeheartedly he is going to show submission. Wholeheartedly. Sarvatmana Asrita Padam, meaning totally he is going to catch, take shelter on the lotus feet of, totally. Not that I am going to believe my husband, my bank, you know, deposit, there's a life insurance. My son is now actually 22 years and he can get nice service, he can also save me. No, this kind of, you know, submission I'm not speaking. It's called temporary submission. You can show. It's one kind of acting. So, Jesam sa esha bhagavan dayoed enanta sarvatmana asrita padam mean, wholeheartedly if you are going to take shelter unto lotus feet of pure Guru Vishnu, how? Usually I give this example. Suppose night time you are sleeping, it happens directly so. It already happened. In Murshidabad, all people, they are sleeping. Suddenly the barrage and the gate, water gate, break down. And night time, huge of water coming. And they are surprised that when they hear the noise of people, they get, they see there is no way. How they can fly? Water already going to, you know, inundate them. Now so current, there's a small baby in the lap of mother going away, floating in water. Father, old father going away. Wife going away. Who can save whom? Practical experience I know. When Damodar barrage break down, sometime it happens so. In that case, one man, he is also, you know, by the current of water going away, but by chance he meet with the branches of banyan tree. Immediately catch the banyan tree. Immediately, and the current is now cannot, you know, take him away. Somehow we catch forcefully and go up and climb the trees by the help of, you know, like Tarzan. Climb the trees there. In that case, he is now safe. Now this example is 100% perfect because now you think you are going to die by the current of water. Somehow by luckily you get the chance to catch that branches of the tree and you can save yourself. Now you try to realize this, you know, feel, direct feeling should be there inside your, what can happen if this kind of thing? What I can do? In that case, how you want to catch that branches of the tree? It is written in English literature that a drowning man catches at a straw. A drowning man is try his best to catch a straw, even a straw, to save himself or herself somehow. When two countries, you know, fighting going on, Pakistan and India or Purva Pakistan, East Bengal at present, that was also Pakistan. some days before. So fighting going on. And where ordinary public, where to go? They are flying. They are taking shelter in Alipurduar, in, you know, Kochbihar, Alipurduar, North Bengal. Somehow they cross, you know, the border and come here. Somehow. Then they are going to get some security here, because Indian government going to give them security. They can take some medicine and food, everything. They can get water, everything, because they are now in shelter. That is called Saranarthi. In Bengali, we say Saranarthi. Saranarthi in Sanskrit also. Saranarthi means shelter. They are going to take shelter. But that shelter is temporary. Someday after, if they feel that condition is changing, they can go back to their country. So it is not permanent shelter. So one wife going to take shelter under the lotus feet of his husband. But that is also not permanent, that is also temporary. But taking shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava is not at all temporary, it's permanent. Be sure, if you are not a cheater, if no duplicity there, then pure Guru Vaishnava going to give you promise. Sure, they can save you. So this way you see, Prabhupada speaking, that if there is no Guru Tattva, if you are not established in Guru Tattva, how we can believe that you can believe Supreme Lord is Dham, Nam? You cannot take darshan of Bhagavan, you cannot take darshan of Dham, Nam, nothing, Vaishnava, nothing, not possible. Prabhupada speaking, what is Guru Darshan? Guru Darshan means each and everywhere, wherever you look, wherever you look, you can see Guru and Guru everywhere. Follow, try to follow my point. Prabhupada speaking, what is Guru Darshan? Wherever those who are established in Guru Tattva, wherever they look, they can see Guru. Directly or indirectly, all Guru. They are going to test us. They are going to put us in trouble to test us, our, you know, sustaining power, our enduring power, how much we can bear. Because already Prabhupada told many times, this material world is the place of painful testing for all bonded soul. Now I can go back to my original point of discussion, that how it is possible for me, whereas I am not at all established in Guru Tattva, I don't believe Guru Tattva. Sometimes if I see something negative, I express doubt, how it is possible. That is not Guru Tattva. That is not 100% believe in Guru Tattva. Wherever you look, wherever you look, you can see Guru everywhere. Wherever you look, anywhere you look, anywhere, everywhere, you can see your Guru everywhere. Anywhere and everywhere, where do you look? Wherever you look, you can find your Guru standing there to protect you from Maya, this, that, always. When you are interested to enjoy Maya, Guru says, hey, you submit unto my lotus feet. Now, you want to enjoy secretly? Don't do. Then Guru can chide me, Prabhupada can chide me. Then I will have to rectify myself. This way, I can get my scope to rectify myself. But Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, you cannot be. Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, how you can say? Mukta Sangasya Pariyayate. Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, Mukta Sangasya Pariyayate. Those who are Mukta Sangha, pure Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, they can give this, you know, Vigyan, direct realization, they can inculcate into my heart, inside my heart. Also, Krishna speaking, Bhagavat 11th canto in front of Uddhav. Hey Uddhav, see, so many I can show you example. They are not going to read Ved, Vedanta, Upanishad, nothing. Nothing they are reading. But still, they reach me. They reach me already. So Krishna speaking in front of Uddhav Ji Maharaj, Uddhav, Bahubhu Matpadam Prapta, Trashta Kaya Dhabadayo, Vrishaparava Valirvano, Mayaschatho Vivishana, Sugriva Hanuman Riksho, Gajo Griddho Vaniko Patho, Vyadaha कुब्जा ब्रजे गोपो यज्ञोपत्नस्तथा परि तेनाधीत सुतिगना नोपासीतो महत्तमः अव्रतात्तप्त तपसा तपसो सत्संग्यात्मम उपागतः व्हाट स्पीकिंग बहुबो मत पदम प्राप्ता त्रष्टा कया धवादयो विश्वपर्वा बलिर्वाणो मयश्चाथो विभीषण सुग्रीवो हनुमान निखो गजो गृद्ध बनिको पथ अथ व्याधः कुब्जा ब्रजे गोपो यज्ञपत्नस्तथा परे ते ना अधितो श्रुतिगना नो उपासीत महत्तमः अव्रता तप्त तपसः सत्संग्याद्माम उपागतः ट्राई टू फॉलो दिस पॉइंट कृष्ण इज डायरेक्टली गिविंग बहुबो मत पदम पत सो मेनी पीपल सो मेनी दे रीचिंग माई लोटस फीट दे ऑलरेडी कम टू मी भगवत तत्व दे नो एवरीथिंग बहुबो मत पदम प्राप्त दे यू नो कम टू माई लोटस फीट दे रीच माई लोटस फीट बहुबो प्राप्त त्राष्टो वृत्वासु त्राष्टो कयाधवादयो कयाधु हिज सन इज प्रह्लाद वृषपर्वा यू नो ऑलरेडी द सन ऑफ प्रह्लाद महाराज विश्वपर्वा बोलिर्बानो बोली महाराज बानो मयश्च अथो विभीषण मयो शाथो विभीषण सुग्रीवो हनुमान निक्षो बल्लुक बल्लु मीन बियर निक्षो गजो जाम्बुबान एक्चुअली सो इज ब्रह्मा अवतार इन दैट केस सो सुग्रीवो हनुमान निक्षो गजो गजराज गजेंद्र मोक्षण यू रीड ना इन कार्तिक बत गजो गृद्ध गृद्ध मीन आई मीन दैट जटायु गजो गृद्ध बनिक पथो व्याध व्याध ऑल्सो बनिको पथो मीन बनिक इधर तिरंडी भिक्षुक यू टूक बनिको पथो बनिक मैंने बिजनेस मैन बनिको पथो व्याध दैट बैद बाय द मर्सी ऑफ यू नो नारदजी महाराज ही कट इज ऑल डाउट एंड यू नो एवरीथिंग एंड कुब्जा अब्रजे गोप्यो वाट टू स्पीक अबाउट गोपिका गोपिका दे यज्ञ पत्नी तथा परे द यज्ञ पत्नी दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू गुरुकुल नथिंग ओनली बाय सत्संग नाउ यू कम टू द पॉइंट व्हाई आई एम स्पीकिंग दिस इवन इफ यू आर नॉट इनिशिएटेड बाय असद्गुरु इट्स स्टिल ओके इफ यू आर इनिशिएटेड बाय हरिकथा स्टिल इट इज ओके यू कैन गेट समथिंग कंक्रीट सो स्टिल यू कैन गेट एंड इफ यूर इनिशिएशन इज फॉल्स And if you are not going to take shelter of Sadguru, then you are going to get great trouble. Also, if you are going to take shelter of the Sadguru, but you don't understand what is Diksha, somehow you get. After that, you are not going to Satsanga. That Diksha become almost useless. Almost. Because you are not going to get any result this life. So, बहवो मत पदम प्राप्तास्त्रष्टा त्रष्टो त्रष्टो कया धवादयो बहवो मत पदम प्राप्ता त्रष्टो कया धवादयो वृषपर्वा बलिर्वाणो मयश्च अथो विभीषणः सुग्रीव हनुमान निक्षो गजो गृद्ध बनिको पथो व्याधः कुब्जा ब्रजो ब्रजे गोपो यज्ञपत्नस्तथा परे तेनाधीत सुति गना नोपासीत महत्तमः अव्रता तप्त तपसो सत्संग्यात्मम उपागतः दे आर नॉट गोइंग फॉर एनी एस्टुडियन फिनांसेस अव्रता तप्त तपसो दे आर नॉट डूइंग एनी तपस्या नथिंग व्रतो नाधीत सुति गना नेवर रीड दे नेवर बीन टू गुरुकुल नथिंग ओनली सत्संग्यात्मम उपागतः By this procedure, Krishna wanted to give us direct information. What is the value of satsanga? So satsangyat mam upagataha. They all reach me only by satsanga. But satsanga prapate pumhir bahubi sukriti prubhasanchitoi. If your sukriti is accumulated, birth after birth, satsanga prapate pumhir. बहुवीर सुकृति पूर्व संचित हुई according to previous, you know, sanskar and sukriti accumulated, then this life you can get satsanga. Even if you are not lucky enough, then you can also disbelieve in Guru Vaishnava. Again you can fall down. To some extent you go up. So this way, all the time there is danger in bhajan. All the time there is danger in bhajan. That's why Guru Padma Paramahansa Sesha Srila Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj used to say, Baba, all the time you will have to remember Nisingadev Prabhupada. He is not speaking about himself, Gurudev, not speaking. But we know that Gurudev, Prabhupada, Nisingadev, all the time, Guru Padma used to give practical example. That if there is countless problem can come, what to speak about me also? Different kind of problem can come to make me powerless. I can give direct example. I'm not going to speak false philosophy. Direct example. Those who are unnecessarily going to pick up some hostility with me, unnecessary. I am not enemy. If anybody want to kill me, still I never think he is my enemy. I think directly, indirectly, all Krishna doing. Maybe it's the arrangement of Krishna. But that's why, Guru Padmani used to speak, Baba, bhakti pat iho kantaka koti ruddho. Baba, my son, this track, this line of bhakti is full of countless strong problem. Countless problem can come in your bhajan life to stop your bhajan, stop your harikatha directly, anyhow. Anyhow, all the time, be careful. Maya can come. Different kind of maya, in the form of enmity, in the form of tantra, mantra, sarayantra, any kind. Directly or indirectly, they can do to stop bhajan, harikatha, everything. It is quite natural. I can give thousand, what to speak about me? I am a small, teeny creature. Even with Prabhupada, out of jealousy, they like to kill Prabhupada many times. They like to stop harikatha. Vaikhanas Maharaj, Vaikhanas Goswami Maharaj, in South India, you hear na Hindi harikatha there, you can remember. Orissa, there I went, Orissa and Andhra border. He is speaking harikatha, and those who are, enemy, the smartha, they arrange tantra mantra. Tantra mantra, in Agam is there, in Atharva Ved, so procedure, avichar yajna, through which one can put someone in trouble, 100% possible. But if pure Guru Vishnu, they can do something externally. They cannot touch, they cannot throw them in from bhajan. But some problem can be there, because Vastu Shakti is there. Vaikhanas Goswami Maharaj, he was supposed to speak Harikatha in some place, he don't know. All tantric, they spend lakhs of rupees to kill Vaikhanas Maharaj. But suppose that time Prabhupada was so powerful, so merciful, that Prabhupada could knew and giving full protection. That's why Vaikhanas Goswami Maharaj was protected. Big problem. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can go, still today it is available in internet. Biskisan and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can go there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur reading Bhagavatam continuously, and that black magic coming here to kill Bhaktivinoda Thakur, moving around. But some damage, they are trying to do some damage. Their family members, Sikh, this, that, they can do something. They cannot do, Bhakti is a natural function of them. Their sorrow is Bhakti. So some problem they can feel. But it is not permanent, it can go away. One day Guru Padma doing bhajan, closing eyes in Kalna Ananta Vasudev temple, in his room doing bhajan. After Aruti, because nobody is there, Guru Maharaj doing Harinam, long time. One man, his name is Barin Babu, he is from Kalna originally, he is going to Calcutta, his service. Guru Maharaj giving him responsibility whenever he is going to Calcutta, he is going to bring something for temple, so many things. He is going to Calcutta and after a Saturday afternoon time, if time permit, or next day, Sunday morning time coming to meet Guru Maharaj to give everything. After that, he is going away. Again, Monday morning, going to join the office. One day, Guru Padmapatma doing Harinam, he pass away to Nitya Leela, nine Leela. And Bharin Babu coming and paying Dandavat and asking, Maharaj, Maharaj not giving any response. Then after that, he was bound to touch the leg of Guru Maharaj. He was bound to touch. And when he touched leg, Guru Maharaj opened eyes. Oh, you, Bharin. Oh, you come already. I couldn't realize. After that, Bharin Babu giving all letters and everything, whatever he need to give to him. After that, Bharin Babu asking Guru Padma, I can ask one question, Maharaj. Yes, yes. I can ask one question. You will have to speak clearly. That when I am calling you, you are not responding. When I catch your leg, as if some 440 volt passing through my body. Not one time, many times. One doctor from Navadvipa also speaking. When your Maharaj giving blessing on my head, touching, if I say current going. So, Guru Padma laughing. What happens? I feel some current, as if some current going on. Guru Padma laughing and speaking. I was doing bhajan, that power gone to you. That power gone to you. So many cases. Even in, in Bhaktamal there. Bhaktamal means it is Nabaji. I am not speaking about Bhaktamal. Haridas ji. During Vaishnav Jivani. All different kind of history of different Vaishnavas. From Vrindavan here, there. Then, it is written there that those Vaishnavas, some Vaishnavas there in, you know, Manasiganga, they are in Govardhan, they are really genuine sadhu. They are doing bhajan. They are not cheater. Not that everybody cheater. They are doing bhajan. They are doing madhukuri. Madhukuri and going to save their, they are not running behind money and nothing. One day, actually from Govinda Mandir, they are invited to take prasadam. They say, oh, we are lucky actually. Because Govinda Mandir actually is Govinda Mandir prasadam. If we get, we are lucky. So we must go. They all coming to take prasadam in Govinda Mandir. But they don't know who is going to arrange that prasadam. They don't know. Somehow they took prasadam. They gone. And night time, their bhajan, there. Bhajan gone, night time, in sleep. They are going to, meet with great trouble. Brahmacharya gone. They are crying in front of Krishna, taking bath and taking, crying. Oh Krishna, what wrong we have done? We are doing Harinam, you cannot protect us. What happened? They are, fasting without water. All groups of sadhu. They are fasting. We want to get, answer from Prabhu, what wrong we have done, so that today we are going to lose our bhajan, everything. Then, just next day, Govinda came in dream, Govinda speaking, Govinda laughing. What to do? What happens? Actually, that prasadam was arranged by a pros. Was by a pros, he leave, he earned his money, he earned her money. Her money was a black money. She earned money through prostitution. And after that he changed her mood by good association. Now she is going to give donation to different temples, ornament, everything in different temples. And rest of the amount he is going to use in Vaishnav Seva. And they are going to get. They don't know the source of that, Then Govindaji speaking, how to balance, how to apportionate, those who are doing statistics, they know, apportionment, disbursion. But it is my usual rule, what to do? Guru Vaishnava doing bhajan, so Guru Vaishnava, somebody like to go up, they will have to take kippa from Guru Vaishnava, knowingly or unknowingly. So you don't know. So if you at all wanted to give honor to my prasadam, why not you took tulsi, like Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj doing? Yes, I am going to give honor to Mahaprasadam. Give me tulsi from the top of this boga and took it. Now, Mahaprasadam is over. You go. Mahaprasadam. Really Mahaprasadam. But in Jagannath temple, you know, there is some arrangement by King Orisha Raja, the government arrange. But usually this way, with Krishna going to apportion it. You can go through the Leela of, you know, Gaur Leela. When Advaita Gosai going to take dust particle from the lotus feet of Gauranga, then when Gauranga coming back in consciousness, forcefully, he is so powerful, Gauranga, catching old Advaita Gosai, catching forcefully and taking, you know, dust parting in from his lotus feet. Well, Advaita Gosai is so powerful, you know. This way, it is the usual rules. And Vaishnav can never suffer, it is true, but they can suffer externally. Internally, their bhakti is there inside their heart. That bhakti is, nobody can disturb if they are Siddha Mahatma. But somehow, externally some problem can be there. I can give you example. Srila Siddhanti Maharaj, who by the desire of Prabhupada, after Prabhupada gone, he published Upanishad, Vedanta, everything, Gauriya Vasya. That Siddhanti Maharaj, as a disciple of Prabhupada, he always used to respect Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, whom you always thinking that my Shiksha Guru. Really so, from house he was brought by this Shiksha Guru. All along, whole life, Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj going to give his temple, everything to Siddhanti Maharaj. And when Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj gone, some disciple of Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, they are going to take undue advantage of the situation. They are so idiot. They are taking sannyas from Siddhanti Maharaj, and Siddhanti Maharaj respects Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, but very secretly they are doing woman association. One sannyasi, two or three, I forget. They are going after Balbog in the morning time, take prasadam and they gone to some place. Siddhanti Maharaj don't know where they gone. Maybe they are sannyasi gone for some preaching or harikatha. But Siddhanti Maharaj came to know every day that two or three sannyasi, they are going to meet with some widow. There is nobody there. They are going and helping that widow this way, there. So many cases. I mean Vyasasan. And not speaking like so many cases, Brahmachari sannyasis, so many cases, this kind of case. So Siddhanti Maharaj giving warning to that two sannyasis. Please don't go there. You have taken sannyas, don't go there. But they are not going to obey. Again Siddhanti Maharaj getting information, they are going same place. Four times speaking, not going to obey. Then one day Siddhanti Maharaj going to catch them and going to take away all vastra, uttariya vastra, and kopin vahirvad. Give me my danda, give me my kopin, give me everything. Snatching all forcefully. Then they become very angry. We are sannyasi. You sannyasi? If you are sannyasi, then why you are not going to? Why Mataji going to message the leg of one Acharya? Why? This is the standard said by Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. This you want to prove? The disciple speaking me, that Maharaj acting as Acharya, his auntie going night time in room and messaging leg. Directly inform me. I say, what to do? This is your Gurudev. What to do? I cannot fight with anybody. Let him do it. I cannot stay. Okay. This way actually all economic manipulation going on. This way Siddhanta Maharaj take away all sannyas with everything. Then after that they took decision, those sannyasis took decision to kill Siddhanta Maharaj. I already told maybe three or four years back, I forget. They're going to take on cutter, you know, chopper. And night time when Siddhanta Maharaj sleeping, with kambal, you know, full body, with head and everything. Then the night time coming in, and they are going to, you know, strike on the body of Siddhanta Maharaj. They wanted to cut the throat of Siddhanta Maharaj. But by chance, by the mercy of Nityananda, that day, Siddhanta Maharaj sleeping opposite way. I mean, the leg was there, and the head was just this way. He was saved, and the blood coming out. And that there was court case. Siddhanta Maharaj went there in court, and the pleader speaking, Maharaj, you look, this is a murderer, attempt to murder case. Is this sannyasi? No? Siddhanta Maharaj looking at him, so merciful, for a long time looking at his face. Maharaj thinking he is already dead body. Where I can dead more, I can kill more. Siddhanta Maharaj speaking, no. What do you say? He is, you know, we catch him. He is, no, he is not. This way, Guru Vaishnava. So, they cannot, you know, put in trouble like Panchapandav. Why? Panchapandav, they are Vaishnava. Externally, they are suffering so much. Their wives are being, you know, their wife, Draupadi is being, you know, this kind of, you know, insult they are doing. They are insulting Draupadi. So many cases. In present days also, I can say. Present days also. So many cases, but directly I don't like to stay here. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj going to Haridwar by car, meet with car accident, and break all his rib in the chest. So if you think he is Vaishnava, how car accident? Bhaman Goswami was speaking, bhajan is totally same, totally separate thing. And this kind of disease, these are totally separate thing. People are in confusion. Sometimes he is in bathroom, fall down and break his, you know, rib. This way Guru Vaishnava also feeling this kind of problem can happen, but they cannot put Guru Vaishnava in full trouble. Like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, little bit. After that, they can get out. This kind of, you know, out of jealousy, somebody can put Guru Vaishnava in trouble. So then you can feel Guru Vaishnava is aprakito. How he is feeling disturbance today? Tithya Goswami Maharaj sitting in Dharma Sabha, cannot speak, is big problem. And repeatedly speaking to Bhaktivinoda Bharati Maharaj. Repeatedly speaking. Oh, Bharati Maharaj must excuse me. Bharati Maharaj must excuse me. Bharati Maharaj must excuse me. Nobody knows why he is speaking so. Nobody knows why he is speaking so. Those who are very clever, they could realize. Because Srila Bharati Maharaj was secretary of Chaitanya Gaudiamath. That post gone somehow. And Tithya Maharaj was not responsible for that. Tithya Maharaj, out of his humble mood, in Sabha itself speaking, repeatedly, Bharati Maharaj must excuse me. Bharati Maharaj must excuse me. Bharati Maharaj must excuse me. If he is not Vaishnava, then why he is going to speak this way, humble way? Vaishnava is always a humble attitude. Eh? Now, some certain incident can happen. That time we can think opposite way, negative way. Is big problem. We cannot believe that Guru Vaishnava is aprakito, how it is possible. Somebody can do some problem, can create. They can create. Even on those days, so what to speak about at present days, it is possible. Out of their jealousy, they can apply some procedure through which they can make somebody, put somebody in trouble. This is possible. Hundreds of procedures there. But Guru Vaishnava never like to take revenge. They can understand, they realize they realize, they can realize this, this is the reason for why I was in trouble. But they never like to take revenge because they are Vaishnava. They never like to take any revenge against anybody. Even Prabhupada speaking, those who are going to, those who like to kill me, Oh Prabhu, there should not be any negative Baba inside my heart for them also. Those who are always expecting my death, because those who are expecting always my death, even Oh Prabhu, there should not be any jealousy inside my heart. There should not be any mood so that I can pray. They can also feed, take some, get some result. Not that. Openly challenge that we can see. We can put you in trouble. Okay, you can put me in trouble. You can do. For some time you can do, but you cannot put me in trouble forever. Now, Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavat Tattva are Aprakita Tattva. Though externally you can find their sickness, this, that, our Guru Varga teaching us, if Guru Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnav not going to express this kind of sick lila, then we cannot get any scope to serve them. This kind of asustha lila they are showing that they are helpless. Santo Goswami Maharaj, Chitta Maharaj, Bhakti Bhavat, Puri Goswami, so many. They are showing that they are helpless. But really they are helpless? They helpless? No! Bhagavan is there. So they want to test us, our belief, how much belief, faith we have. You can remember long ago I was speaking that some disciples of Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj went to hospital, to nursing home hospital, to see Gurudev. Then three devotees gone. They are, you know, standing in corridor and watching Guru Maharaj through window. And they are speaking, one senior devotee there, speaking, this is the pipeline through which urine going. This is the pipeline through, you know, this blood, you know, they are giving blood. Here is a saline, this line. This way they are explaining Guru Tattva. The Madhav Goswami Maharaj hearing everything from bed. Madhav Goswami Maharaj hearing their discussion, that is a Guru Tattva, Guru Darshan. They are coming to see Gurudev, his sickness, his inability. Yeah. And Madhav Goswami Maharaj shedding tears heavily. Madhav Goswami Maharaj shedding tears heavily. And they are speaking outside that this is Gurudev. So this is our Guru Tattva. But sometimes you forget this point. I repeatedly told, until and unless you are not going to enjoy full kipa of pure Guru Vaishnava, your brain cannot touch that aprakita jagat, cannot get in touch with aprakita jagat. Only material conception can persist. Only material conception can persist inside your heart. Never you can have 100% faith. The day you grow 100% faith in Guru Vaishnava, be sure you can grow 100% faith in Harinam also. 100% faith in Leela, Parikar, Vaishya, or everything eternal you can believe immediately. Now from Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, first canto, 11th chapter, perhaps you know, those who are sannyasi brahmacharya, I don't know, they going to discuss this point or not. I can give so much example. It is written in 11th chapter, first canto, 38 number slok. Etad ishanam mishasso prakritistha yopi etad gunai. Na jujjate sadatmastair jatha buddhistadasraya. Etad ishanam ishasya prakritistho yopi tadgunoi. Na jujjate sadatmastair jatha buddhistadasraya. What I speak? Etad ishanam ishasya prakitistha yopi tad gunai na yujyate sadatmasthair yatha buddhi tadasraya. What do you mean? It means that this is the divinity of the personality of Godhead. He is not affected by the qualities of material nature, even though in contact with them. Many times I discussed before on those days, previous days. Similarly, devotees who have taken shelter of the Supreme Lord never influenced, affected by the mundane qualities. Be careful about this point. They are also a prakrit. And also I told that day that no janma karma bandhanam vaishnavanam cha vidvati. Janma karma, taking birth, you know, suffering something, is nothing there in by externally they are, you know, showing. No janma karma bandhanam vaishnavanam cha vidvati. For Vaishnava, there is no karma bandha. There is no bondage, karma bandha. They are not doing something out of their, you know, out of the result of their previous, not that. All their activities are in favor of bhakti. They are doing bhakti. Even if you find that jada jada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhuthanam adharmasya tadatmanam siyamyaham paritranayo sadhunam vinasaya cho duskitam. Here, actually, you can go through this commentary of Viswanatha Chakravarti that we know that Guru Vaishnava never want to take revenge against anybody. I already told, Guru Vaishnava never tried, even somebody like to kill him. Okay. But never like to take any revenge. They can understand who is doing what. So, actually, paritranayo sadhunam vinasaya cha duskitam. Why it is written? Bhagavan coming in this material world when adharma is, you know, increasing extensively. And after that, it is written there, vinasaya cha duskitam. To protect all sadhu, to give full protection to sadhu. Paritranayo sadhunam means to protect them from danger, and vinasayacho duskritam. Those are duskriti, those who always try to put Guru Vaishnava in trouble, they like to destroy everything, their demon, to kill them. Prabhu coming here. Now Vishwanatha Chakravarti is speaking. We know Guru Vaishnava never demand anything from Supreme Lord. Never. Guru Vaishnava never going to take any revenge. Nothing, no negative thing is there inside their heart. Still it is written, why? Because they are not going to pray unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan, oh Prabhu, you come and protect us. Vishwanatha Chakravarti was speaking, sometime Guru Vaishnava speaking, oh Prabhu, protect me, give me. But Vishwanatha Chakravarti was saying, sometimes they shout this way, but they are not habituated. Sometimes they shout, Prabhu, Prabhu, help me, protect me, they speak. Like Jarabharat ji, when Vrishalpati going to put the head of Jarabharat into the cutting place in front of Bhadrakali and going to take the sharp weapon, to cut from the hand of Kali and going to apply some vermilion red. Oh Ma, going to cut the head, you know, throat of Jarabharat. It is written there, come on, it is written there. Pranaki Cheopi. Big problem there. But still then Jarabharat ji not going to pray unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan. Oh Prabhu, what wrong I have done so that you are going to cut me through this Vrishalpati? No complaint. prana kriccha gate api, when he's going to leave his body, still Jarabharat not going to pray unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. What problem, Prabhu? What wrong I have done? Why you are going to cut through? No, no complaint. No complaint, no complaint, nothing. Jarabharat ji resting very nicely. Prahlad Maharaj, you can see, go through the life history of Prahlad Maharaj. Hiranyakasipu like to put him in fire, giving poison, Kalkut beast, throwing him from the hilltop into ocean. All the time, Prahlad Maharaj doing one single thing. What is that? Eh? Sri Vishnu Swarane Parikshit Abhavad Vyasaki Kartan Kirtane Prahlad Smarane. Eh? Follow Prithu Pujane and Lakshmi Tadangri Sevane. This way, all different acharya we can see that each of them are busy with one fold of bhakti. Out of nine fold of bhakti, I can discuss next day. Out of nine fold of bhakti, we can get such acharyas, such acharyas, they are busy with one devotional fold. Some with Angri Sevan, some with, you know, Swaran, Prahlada Smaran, Parikshit actually hearing Harikatha, Sukhdev Goswami speaking Harikatha. This way, one fold. That's why Mahaprabhu speaking, Ekango Sadhe Kimba Sadhe Bahu Ango. Ekango Sadhe Kimba Sadhe Bahu Ango. Nishtha Hoite Upajaya Premettarango. Sometime we can find one devotee is following one fold of bhakti. Sometime two or three folds of bhakti at a time. Ekango sadhe kimba sadhe bahu ango. Nishtha hoite upajaya premet tarango. If there is nishtha, strong belief, nishtha, then they can get success in their bhajan. So this way we can find that one fold of bhakti can give siddhi. So what to speak about? So only we should believe. Because unlike conditioned souls, ever immersed in Maya, they are always ever immersed in Maya. Pure devotees remain inside Bhakti Sagar, in the ocean of bhakti. All the time, knowingly, unknowingly, they are going to show bhakti. They are all activities. All their activities, they are actually always bhakti. Unlike conditioned souls, they are ever immersed in Maya, pure devotees remain always immersed in intense love affair with Krishna, seva. Thus, infusing each moment of even their seemingly routine affairs with the ecstasy of their hearts craving for Krishna. All the time, there a Vaishnava is fully engaged in bhakti, in the service, even before his apparent birth. Guru Vaishnava, they are coming here in the material world to help me, again going away. Nitya Siddha Mahatma. Those who are not Nitya Siddha, Sadhan Siddha, from today onward, they are going to climb that eternal world. From today onward, their eternal existence is pakka in eternal world. So a Vaishnava is fully engaged in that service, eternal service, even before his apparent birth. And upon leaving the plane of material vision, he returns to the realm of eternal service there in Golok Vrindavan, Vrindavan, all the time. This is actually Siddhanta, all the time. So, now point is that those who are expressing doubt about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his associates, about Guru Vaishnava, for them it is my apple to them. You try to consider this sloka, etad Ishanam Ishasya Prakritistha Opi. Though it seems Bhagavan is coming here in the material world, just there, you know, playing with material man and everything, you know, in with his parika, it seems Bhagavan is not playing with material man, I mean parshads. And it seems Bhagavan is there within this material world, all, you know, nature of Prakriti going to influence him. It is one kind of leela. One kind of leela. Nothing else. So you can remember actually that when we are going to believe 100% Guru Vaishnava, then we can get some extraordinary facility. 100% we can get some facility. That is why when Mahaprabhu was speaking with that Brahman there, where they are in Allahabad, you can remember Allahabad, Raghupati Upadhyay, in front of Raghupati Upadhyay, Mahaprabhu asking some point. Raghupati, what bhajan you like? Whom you can do bhajan? What bhajan you like? Actually, Raghupati Upadhyay speaking in a very smiling mood. Prabhu, Srutim apare sritim itare bharatamanne bhajant bhavabhitaha ahamiya nandam bande jasya alinde parabrahma. Srutim apare sritim itare bharatam anne bhajantu bhavabhitaha ahamiya nandam bande jasya alinde parabrahma. Now you can feel this guru tattva here. Somebody can go through Sruti, Veda, Sriti, Agam, Nigam, everything. Srutim apare sritim itare bharatam anne bhajantu bhavabhitaha ahamiya nandanam bande nandang bande yasya alinde parabrahm. He is speaking. Somebody going to read Sruti, Veda, somebody Sriti, you know, Manusriti, big, more than Mahabharat, big, big, oh, what to do, what not to do all. Sruti mapare, Sriti mitare, a Bharatamanne, somebody can read Mahabharat also. Bhajantu Bhavapita, they like to cross over this material ocean, and Mahabharat, Ramayana, all, it is Joy Grantha, you know, Joy Grantha mean, if you take shelter of that Grantha, you can cross over this material world. But Prabhupada speaking, don't go through Mahabharata. You can put yourself in confusion. Be careful. Always try to go through Chaitanya Bhagavata, Chaitanya Charitamrita. You can, otherwise you cannot understand. You can grow confusion. So, it is really so. Sutim apare sritim itare bharatam anne bhajantu bhavavita ahamiya nandanam nandang bande. Raghupati Upadhyay is speaking, I like to worship Nanda. But why? I like to worship Nanda because if I catch Nanda, then I can get Krishna. Ahamya Nandanang Bande Jasalinda Parabrahma. In the courtyard, in the courtyard of Nanda Maharaj, Parabrahma is crawling, is playing. So I can catch Nanda Maharaj. So if I go directly, I cannot come out successful. So better I can take shelter of Nanda Maharaj. Ahamya Nandanam Bande Jasalinda Parabrahma. So I can get. This is called Guru Tattva. So if you like to get Nitya Seva, if you like to go to the eternal world, then you will have to believe Guru Vaishnava 100%. They can 100% help you. The more you can believe, the more you can get facility. This is the point. So, etat ishanam ishasya prakritistho opi, though he is inside nature, within this immaterial world. Prakritistho opi tat gunoi, na jujyate, by the nature, that the material modes of nature cannot touch him. Sadatmasthair jatha buddhi tadasraya. You know, always he is free. Like Atma, is never going to be influenced by your vice and virtue. You know, sorrow, you know, or bliss, nothing, material bliss. Because Atma is totally separate thing. Like, you are standing just at the bank of a lake, water lake. You can find your picture is there inside this water. Follow? You can find your picture is there. After some time, one big wind coming, and you can find all your body is, you know, vibrating. But it is not, it seems that your body is vibrating, you know, shaking. But actually it is the reflection of your body is there inside water, and that water is, you know, restless. That's why it seems that your body is restless. Actually your body is not, you know, going to be influenced by that air. It's one place. Similarly, your Atma in pure form, can never be influenced by material natures, vice and virtue, or pain, or suffering, you know, enjoyment, nothing, material enjoyment, nothing. That's why that day I was speaking, Krishna speaking to Arjuna, that I am not going to accept any vice and virtue of Jivatma. Jehi sangsparse ja bhogaha, any kind of tangible facility, enjoyment, they are always running for material enjoyment. Jehi sangsparse ja bhogaha, duksha janaye evate. It is the ultimate cause of, you know, painful, you know, life. So, jaihi sangsparsaja bhoga duksha jana evate. It can give you pain. And this kind of enjoyment can ultimately put you in the ocean of misery. Jaihi sangsparsaja bhoga duksha jana evate. Adyanta vanta kantiyo nati suramati buddha. It has some beginning and end. Material enjoyment, material pain, material, you know, vice and virtue, anything, has some beginning and end. That's why Panchapandav never demand from Krishna, oh well, you are our brother, you are friend, why we are in trouble? What is your supremacy then? Huh? What is the supremacy? You are Supreme Lord, we are in trouble. This kind of demand never can come in the life of Yudhishthira Maharaj, Panchapandav, Drupadi, or, you know, Kunti Devi, never. On the contrary, Kunti Devi expressing this mood, Prabhu, you send different kind of trouble. You please put us in trouble, big trouble. Why? Man, if you put us in trouble, then we can feel saranagati. And through saranagati, we can see you inside our heart. And now Krishna speaking, now your all problem is over. Bua. Oh, you know, auntie, all problem is now over. Kurukshetra Yudha is over. And now, Yudhishthira Maharaj, Rasya Yoga, is successful. Now I like to take leave from you. Kunti Devi, come on. Now, no problem here. Kunti Devi, now actual problem starting. What do you see? What do you mean? Bua, auntie, what do you mean? Actually, I mean to say, now actual problem starting. Where problem? Actually, all enemies, they are finished, everything. No, actual problem now starting. Because now, there is no opponent party. So, we always expect some opponent, unnecessarily, they can put us in trouble. They can try to bring some defame in our life. Shambhava is so, this, that, so they can speak all rubbish. We expect. In that case, if opponent party is very strong, then always I can feel humble mood. I can show Saranagati Krishna, what problem was there, I couldn't speak. This way humble mood can come. Otherwise you can say popped up mood, I am big Acharya. No, not that. Always you think, according to the situation, we will have to feel all the time. You know, All the time we'll have to feel that we are helpless. Krishna, Guru Vaishnava is there. So Krishna sometimes testing us. Haridas Thakur is there doing bhajan, Harinam. Haridas Thakur not doing bhajan, not doing Harinam to earn some name and fame and money, bank balance. Haridas Thakur doing Harinam because he like to do Harinam. We are doing devotion, bhakti, why? For bhakti. Bhakti for bhakti. Bhakti for something. There is any cause? Well, no. We are showing bhakti, we are doing bhakti to get bhakti. Nothing else. No other reason can be there. So, Namacharya Haridas Thakur doing bhajan there. You see how, you know, humble Haridas Thakur, how innocent, but still there is some opponent part to what to speak about you and me. What to speak about you and me. He's good, actually. So, Haridas Thakur doing Harinam, but still Ramchandra Khan become very angry. Ah, so, you know, he's earning so name and fame. He is doing 3 lakhs Harinam, all world going to name. Oh, let me do something. Let me bring some defame in his life. I can send some pros to show people that he is characterless. This way all the time. This way all the time in the history of creation. If you go, and Tulsidas ji doing bhajan, he is not criticizing anybody. Somebody criticizes, yes, idiot, you know, speaking of. Always try to bring some problem in his life, in the life of. Then somebody speaking, oh Tulsidas ji, that sadhu so much, he is going to criticize you all the time. Oh, then I can do one thing, I can bake some, you know, madhukuri and make one bhajan. You don't understand what he meant to say. What do he is criticizing you. That's why I want to make bhajan kuti in front of my bhajan kuti. And he can do bhajan there. He can go on criticizing. I cannot see my own fault. He can go on detecting one by one fault. Different kind of faults may be there, must be there. So he can detect, I can rectify myself and go to Ramchandra. Very good. So let him criticize. Let them put us in trouble. If the river coming down from the mountain, you know, that like Ganga, Alakananda, Saraswati, Jamuna, all coming from the hilly place, being high. You know, in that case, any kind of barrier coming, you know, cannot stand. I have seen many times, and I've been in Himalaya hill. I was feeling how teeny I am in front of this and great Himalaya. Guru Maharaj told you, go, try to discover, try to realize your, you know, futile, you know, effort. Try to understand, try to feel how you know, useless you are. Try to go. So in front of, you know, Rudra Prayag, evening time and standing and watching. Oh my God! Is, you know, river coming. And there is so sound. And I was feeling, standing just there in hilly place and watching. This is our life, you know. This is our unstable life. And we are going to express vanity, false ego. This is a mood. So, the more we are going to meet with barrier, somebody can stop our speech. I've been to, you know, some days before. It is open secret. I'm not making one new philosophy. All devotees, they know it. I've been to Midnapur, Chandrakarna. For past 2 months, they are planning how to stop Harikatha. How Sambhava can become very sick, cannot speak. They challenge. They can do something, and they can put, they can take some power, you know, unknowingly. Maybe I am busy with my bhajan, they can take some power from me. But they cannot put me in trouble forever. This is quite natural, they can put. So they say it is open secret. Everywhere I cannot speak, all prohibited. Because I am speaking about all Guru Bhargava, say they don't like, they cannot digest it. Indigestion problem, they are coming, they are feeling, so better Just 2 months before, 2-3 months before, I've been to, you know, Puri, Prabhupada Abhirbhav Tithi. So long, Bharti Maharaj was there, I was feeling so happy because Bharti Maharaj speaking in front of me. Bharti Maharaj giving order, Sambhava, you must speak. Now they are managing manipulation so that Sambhava cannot speak. Everybody in a open secret. Everybody in a. Some devotee is sitting in front of me after Maharikata, Maharaj. Some of your Godbada, black, he putting pressure on this, you know, those who are going to, you know, going to arrange the Sabha, he's putting pressure, you stop Sambhava's Harikatha. He directly told me, everybody know, he is pushing Maharaj to stop his Harikatha. So I am laughing, let them do. Or they can, some black procedure, white procedure, they can make me sick. They can do to stop my Harikatha. But heart, they cannot change me. They cannot change my heart. Hey, it's not possible. Now I can also discuss another sloka, because tamayam mannate loko hi asaktyam opi sanginam atmopammenam manujam vyapinanam yato abidha. Ajnan manav, those who are ignorant people, they can never understand. They can never understand Bhagavad Tattva, they cannot understand Vaishnava Tattva. Ajnan manav, they think Guru Vaishnava is just like us. Chapal Gopal wanted to make some problem, you know, Chapal Gopal going to put some red China rose, some pot of wine, and some vermilion, everything red, all dirty things, he put. They gone. In the morning time, when Sivaspani opening door, finding this, is calling to all gentlemen, you come, you see night time what I am doing, all rubbish, with wine, you know. Then those who are really intelligent, they are crying. Who has done this? Who is the miscreant? Then within one or two days, he developed leprosy. Within 1 or 2 days, he developed leprosy. They are now crying in front of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu say, you are Vaishnava Paradi. I don't like to see your face. What problem you are facing at present? It is nothing. You will have to suffer birth after birth. It is nothing. Be careful. He was not excused. Even Vishwanath, Kashi Vishwanath, he wanted to approach Kashi Vishwanath through Ganga boat. That when that, you know, great Vaishnava brother reaching Varanasi Ganga, then Bhagavati, Annapurna, you know, shouting in front of Pujari, hey! Some great aparadhi, I don't like to see his face, he's going to touch this Varanasi. Don't allow him, I like to touch this Varanasi. Don't allow, because otherwise I can destroy everything through earthquake. Be careful. Don't allow him to touch. Then he was not allowed to land. He was not allowed to land in the land. He was not allowed to land in Varanasi. Then again he came back. You see, this is the condition. So those who are material people, out of their material darshan, they always think that Guru Vaishnava is just like us. They are also for some time feeling sick, this, that. And also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu feeling sick, Leela, medicine, Krishna also. This way, when Prabhu coming in this material world, in that case, Prabhu going to follow exact rule. That is called excellency. When Krishna is actually taking the form of Narayan and going to kill, you know, Sakotasur or Putana, then what is the excellency? Excellency lying in this factor that Krishna's 6 months boy, small, very soft boy, and Putana going to catch him and going to give breast full of poison. Then Putana, you know, taking away. Then Balgopal playing this kind of, that is called excellency. That's why Ramchandra coming here in the material planet, crying for a wife, oh Sita, where you gone? Everybody think they like material man. Like material man, Ramchandra crying, everybody can think. So, tamayam mannate loko hi asaktam opi sanginam atmopammenam manujam vaprinanam jato abudha. Those who are not intelligent, those are foolish. Those who are materially attached, their material attachment is there inside their heart. They think, it's just like us. Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, they are just like us. Krishna is like us. He is also playing with woman, this, that. Parikshit Maharaj, that's why wanted to put so many questions in front of Gurudev. On behalf of us, common people. That Krishna is Atmaram. Then why Krishna is feeling dissatisfaction going to play with woman? Why? What's that? Must be some problem there. Then Parikshit Maharaj putting this kind of question. How it is possible that Krishna can show this kind of lila? It is totally prohibited. But Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, what prohibited? What prohibited? He is the Supreme Lord. Where not? Krishna is there everywhere. Where not? Krishna is staying inside the heart of everybody. So what problem? Tat gopinam cha tat patinam sarvesham eva dehinam yantas charaha savadhyakhya kirana neha dehavak. Gopinam tat patinam cha sarvesham eva dehinam. Inside the heart of gopis, inside the heart of those husband of gopis, where not? Krishna everywhere. When Krishna coming, you know, expressing this kind of lila, what wrong in it? There is no problem for Krishna. There is no problem. We should not have any complaint with Krishna. All what Krishna doing is all very nice. No problem. Ishwar Buddhi, Ishwar, Supreme Lord is always, you know, nirapeksha, nishango. Always, you know, never Prakriti can touch him. What to speak about Prakriti? Prakriti is staying backside Krishna, not even coming front, in front of Krishna. Because Mayadevi feeling shy. Mayadevi feeling shy to come in front of Krishna. Follow, because I am doing this so dirty job actually, and I am putting all bonded soul in prison, giving them punishment, these, that, so many things. I am going to grant material, you know, benediction to all people. Dhanam dehi, janam dehi, jaso dehi, ma. Eh? All is speaking, na? They are speaking, na, in front of Mataji. Oh ma, give me. Give me honor, give me, you know, money, you know, manpower, money. Dhanam dehi, janam dehi, jaso dehi, matar. Eh? Disho johi. But Vaishnav cannot speak that way. Vaishnav cannot speak that way. One day, I was in Jambu. Long time, 5-6 years back. I was in 7 years back, maybe, I forget. I was in Jambu, all devotees, they take me forcefully there, some sannyasis also there. They engage me in special harikatha. One day I was at the bank of Jhilam Nadi, and though some Rajaji, they are from Jambu, he forced me. Maharaj, here they are arranging Devi Bhagavat. They are reciting Devi Bhagavat, one Mataji coming with red cloth. He is reciting Devi Bhagavat. And they request me, Maharaj, you speak something. It is inauguration. I say, what to speak? As they are going to read Devi Bhagavatam. And that Mataji is sitting at least 5 feet up me. I am not feeling insulted. They speak me. Maharaj, you can speak something. Okay. No, Maharaj like to go there because they feel insulted. I go plain way. I go and started speaking Harikatha, sitting down. The Mataji is there up. And Mata is always up. Mataji is always up to me. I am very, you know. Then I was speaking, explaining these different slokas from Bhagavatam. They are there. Very short period, only within 15 minutes. Within 15, 20 minutes, I draw conclusion. I finish and I jump from the stage and come. And that Mataji is there up. He started, you know, glorifying me. He started glorifying. Today this Baba coming to give us enjoyment, speaking this way. So everybody, they are dancing actually. Now they give me 500 rupees pranami. 7 years back, 500 rupees pranami is not a matter of joke. 7-8. I take this pranami. I again run to the stage and give this pranami to that Mataji. Ma, you take it. You take it. He saw you. Yes, he has become very happy again. He started glorifying. Oh, Gauri Amar devotee, you see. This way, I was explaining. Dhanam dehi, janam dehi, jaso dehi, diso johi. Diso mean all enemy. Oh, ma, you can kill all my enemies. Are Maharaj, I have no enemy. So how I can pray in front of you? Like Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, na? Eh? Paritranayo sadhunam vinasaya chuduskritam. Are Maharaj, sadhu never going to pray in front of Prabhu that you try to give punishment to those enemy, kill them. But it is written in Gita. Now Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, paritranayo sadhunam vinasaya chuduskritam means those sadhu, they are feeling separation, pain. That's why from this kind of pain, they like to pray to Krishna so that Krishna can come and deliver them. Vijinarnavam. Vijinarnavam means Vijinarnavam mean ocean of misery. Ocean of misery, but not material misery. Ocean of misery created by the separation from Krishna. We are separated from, O Krishna, save us, Vijinarnavam. We are inside, amidst the ocean of Vrijana. Vrijana means, you know, sufferings. What is the suffering? Suffering, painful, and you know, suffering of separation. So, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking, they never think that there is some enemy, because they know 100%. Otherwise, he cannot speak Harikatha. He is feeling somebody going to put me in trouble, and if he thinks he is my enemy, then surely he cannot speak Harikatha. Because Harikatha means 100%, if you are not established in Advaigan Tattva, just in 2 hours before I was speaking, until and unless you can find all your Guru Tattva everywhere. Wherever you look, you can find directly or indirectly all Guru Tattva. If this kind of condition not coming in your life, then your Harikatha is useless Harikatha. You should not speak Harikatha. Where is other Tattva? There is one and a single Tattva, Advaigan Tattva. So Achinta Vedavet Tattva, Bhakto, Bhagavan, everything they are playing, but still it is Advaigan Tattva. Who are you? Who are you to feel that Guru Vaishnava is material? Who are you to feel Krishna is material? Are there is no Tattva. Where from you are coming? Why you think that I am a separate tattva? He should feel from your heart that there is no tattva. Only devotees there, you know, Achinta Vedave, simultaneously different or non-different from Krishna. This tattva, if you can realize, in that case, you can come out successful. No doubts can be there. Aham bhakta praradhino hi asatanta ivodijo. Aham bhakta paradhino. I am bhakta paradhin. I am regulated by devotees. Are you are actually satantra, it is written. Eh? You are Satanta in Bhagavata, it is written. Okay, okay, it is written. But there is another, there is one world. There is a separate world where Prema, where Prema going to guide me. Prema of devotees, my devotees, my Bhakta. My Bhakta can make me dancing. That's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Radhikar Prem Guru Ami Shishya Not. Radhikar Prem Guru Ami Shishya Not. Jakhon Joiche Nachai Nachiye Udbhat. Radhikar Prem, the love of Radharani is my Guru. Radharani is my Guru. Radharani is the feature of, you know, full figure of Prema. Feature. Radhikar Prem Guru Ami Shishya Not. I am disciple. As and when Radharani given gesture, hey, dance, dance, then I start dancing. I have no personality, nothing. Hey? A special personality. Not personality is not there, not. Not material personality is not there. Also, we can find so many sloka in 11th canto, Krishna speaking to Uddhavji Maharaj. I can discuss someday, no time cannot permit today. And also, you know, and Mandir Patishtha book, my Guru Maharaj used to establish temple, temple, deities, so many. So I have some experience actually. I am not going to install any deity, I don't like. I like only Harikatha. I don't know why. This seva I like, Harikatha and Kirtan writing, this I like, I don't know why. Maybe by the mercy of Gurudev, I like this seva. All deity installation, these there, I don't like. Let somebody do it. So, it is there written, I am going to publish one book, first in Bengali, and who can translate, I know, I don't know, I am paying thousands of rupees for translating, but still proper translation I cannot get. And even, you know, I am keeping some pranami separately, I am paying, that day I was paying, you know, 5,000 rupees, that day, just 2 days before. Because I like to help them, okay, if they can get some inspiration. Because material people, they cannot get inspiration. I give them, okay, you take it, okay. I am going to spend for Hari Bhajan. You know, you take it, you need money, so you translate. And maybe 48, is actually 95 pages maybe. You know, 95. Maybe, so Bhaktivinoda Thakur book, I am going to publish in English. But it will take time, now I am busy with this Harikatha. And recitation for long time I am feeling uneasy. And speaking to devotees. Never before this happened. I was feeling some problem. Whenever I start some cough coming. If I go on reciting very nicely, in between after 1 or 2 hour cough coming, then I have to cancel the whole file. Again starting. So this way, from today, morning time, 7 o'clock, I am feeling something good. As if some uneasy, unusual feeling I am feeling. Maybe something is there. So now, today is okay. Still, due to age actually, previously I used to recite Bhagavatam like wind. Like wind. But that time I was young. Now age growing up, you know. So in Hayasitsa Pancharatra, one book, very documentary, it is usually we take document from this book about installation of deity. It is written that Krishna speaking that actually Vastropo Bita Varanam Vastropo Bita Varana Patra Srab Gandha Lepanai Alankurvito Sapremo Mad Bhakto Mang Jatho Chitam. What I mean to say, why I quote this sloka? I select this sloka actually. I was thinking that how we can understand the deity, Bigraha Nau Tumi Shakshat Bhajan. Many times I give so many examples, but still today I can also give some example from the life of Prabhupada. One example I can before finish. So our starting is Pavitvat, middle is Prabhupada. For starting Prabhupada, middle Prabhupada, end Prabhupada, sarvatra, everywhere, full of Prabhupada, his Siddhanta. वस्त्रो उपबीताभरणो पत्रो स्रगंध लेपणई अलंकुर्वीत सब प्रेम मद भक्तो माम यथोचितम। कृष्ण स्पीकिंग दैट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ क्लोथ ऑर्नामेंट गार्लैंड एंड एसेंस एंड एवरीथिंग यू कैन अप्लाई इन माय बॉडी बॉडी ऑफ डेइटी माम मधुभक्तो माम यथोचितम। दिस माम माम वर्ड मीन कृष्ण वांट टू मीन दैट माय डेइटी एंड आई मायसेल्फ नॉन डिफरेंट अलंकुर्वित सब प्रेमो मधुभक्तो माम। व्हाई कृष्ण स्पीकिंग माम इट इज द डेइटी इट इज डेइटी वेयर एज कृष्ण स्पीकिंग माम दैट्स मीन यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट कृष्ण वांट टू स्पीक माय डेइटी एंड आई मायसेल्फ नॉन डिफरेंट just equal. So try to understand this point, try to understand this point that Krishna speaking my deity, actual deity installed by Sadhuguru Vaishnava Piyo is just equal to I myself, no difference. Vigraha na tumi sakshat Brajendranandan. I can speak from the life history of Srila Prabhupada, all Siddhanta I am speaking, all I borrow from Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I have nothing myself. So Prabhupada, one Gaur Purnim, there was a big flood, and Prabhupada's thinking, her doing Harinam and thinking, is there is big flood, I cannot offer Paramanna nothing to Krishna, to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu today, my Prabhu, because there is flood, big flood, big flood, all inundated everywhere, low and high places all. In the meantime, one milkman coming with big pot, big powerful man, you know, almost up to his chest water coming, and giving this donation to the Jogpitsi Mandir, to Pujari. And Prabhupada got information, Prabhupada started crying. Pujari, it was the instruction that you cannot accept anything and everything, you have to understand who is bringing what purpose, who is bringing this strict instruction. Then that milkman giving all, you know, mola sage, you know, milk, everything, rice, everything, and speaking that jamindar, that landlord, send me, he is devotee actually, he loved Prabhupada very much. Prabhupada started crying, Prabhu, I have given you so much pain today. At all, I wanted to take the test of Paramanna. Why I am thinking that way? So that you are going to take trouble today to bring Paramanna everything for me, you know, milk and everything for me. Same thing happened when Sanatan Goswami came to meet Rupa Goswami, you know. And Rupa Goswami wanted to arrange a Paramanna for Sanatanji, Gurudev. He thinking, where from I get? Because there is no milk, no molasses, nothing is there. And how I can? I wanted to make Paramanna for my Gurudev, Sanatan. Immediately one small girl coming, Baba, 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 what happens? Baba, Mayyane bhej diyo, Mayyane bhej diyo. My mother sent all this thing to you. What? Rupa Goswami had gone mad. This milk, you know, mola sage, you know, rice, he started, you know, crying. I'm making Paramanna and offering to Krishna, Radharani. And again, I bring this prasadam in front of Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami is speaking all Siddhanta Tattva, Kirtan, and when he started taking Paramanna, he went to take Paramanna from pot and putting in his, you know, mouth, he stunned, he becomes stunned. What? I'm taking Paramanna, or what is it? Why? Are his excellency there? As if I feel some current going on. Oh, that girl must be Radharani. You should not think that way. You should not have, think that way. Why you are thinking that way? That's why Radharani taking trouble to bring milk and, you know, rice, molasses, everything. Why you are thinking that way? You should not think that way. From today onward, be careful. This way, Paramananda was cooked. So we have no belief in Supreme Lord, in Guru Vishnu. Some devotee can believe. Some devotee can believe. Different letters I am writing to them. They are also sending their letter. I become very happy to see their mood. They feel I am there with them. Thousands of miles away in America they are staying. They think Maharaj is there with me. You are with me. So I am very happy. It's the arrangement of Gurudev and Prabhupada. But I am a penniless man, beggar. What I can do? Preaching. Preaching is not possible for me at all. Acha, next day I can discuss how Krishna can play in such a way so that you cannot avoid material conception. Somebody putting question, Maharaj, if Shankar Bhagavan is there, if Bhagavan is there, if Devi Maa is there, why they are not going to take step? What step? They are saying, Maharaj, we learned from history that at least 18 times Gajanis, one demon, Gajanis from Arabian country came to loot, you know, Somnath temple, Somnath Mandir of Mahadev in Gujarat. But why Mahadev not coming out to kill those demons? They're thinking, no, I can give answer next day so that you can have some, you know, curiosity. Why Shankar Bhagavan not coming out to take action? Why not? I can give answer next day. So you must wait up to that point. So Sujanar Budaradito Pado Jugam Jugodharma Durandharo Patrobaram Baradavayodaya Kapuya Padam Pranamami Sada Prabhupada Padam Pranamami Sada Prabhupada Padam Pranamami Sada Prabhupada Padam Vancha Kalpadurvasya Kepa Sindhu Bhavacha Patitanam Pavanu Bhavacha Bhyo Namo Namo.